Do customers sometimes give you a bad check? Well, even though that's a bad experience, it won't be difficult to record the bounce check in QuickBooks Online. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comment section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. There are three things that need correcting when the bank records a customer's bounced check. First, your bank account must be decreased by the amount of the bounced check. And this amount must be added to the customer's balance in accounts receivable because the customer now owes you the money for the bounced check. Secondly, you must record the fee that the bank charged you as a result of the bounced check, and you really should charge your customer a service fee for the service of managing this customer's bounced check. Now these last two are very easy to do, and if you're in this course, you probably already know how to do them. But let's focus on this first step. It only takes a minute to set up. In order to set up to be able to do step number one, all you have to do is add an item to the items list and connect it to the bank account. Let's call this item Customers Bounced N.S.F. check. So here we are in QuickBooks Online, and we're going to click the cog wheel, and we're going across to this list of products and services. Now, we could, of course, click new, and it could be either a service or a non-inventory part. Either of these types will work fine. I like to choose non-inventory part so it's clear that it's not the normal service that we give. And I believe the name will be Customers Bounced NSF Check. Now, all we have to do is connect it to the actual bank account. We click Save and Close. And now you can see this item has been added to the items list. Now we'll do an example. Let's imagine on April 1, we received a notice from the bank that check number 5678 from Candy, dated March 6th and deposited on March 9th, has been returned as an NSF check, and the amount of the check is $2,660. They charged you $30 for someone else's mistake, and you should charge Candy $50 just for dealing with this. Now again, these are the three steps that you have to take, and let's focus on step number one. Your bank account must be decreased by the amount of the bounce check, and this amount must be added to the customer's balance in accounts receivable. How do you do this? Well, it's very simple. All you have to do is make an invoice for Candy dated April 1, which is the day the bank deducted the amount from the account, and on this invoice, use the item we just created, Customer's Bounce Check. This will both correct the balances of the bank account and the customer's receivable account, while at the same time, it gives you an invoice that you can give to the customer and make it clear why they have to pay. Let's go ahead and record this invoice for Candy. To do this, you open the New Transaction menu. Either click on the top left where it says New, or if you don't have that, go to the top right and click the plus sign close to the cog wheel. Either one will open the same choices in the New Transaction menu. And we go across to Invoice. We make sure we have the right customer, Candy, and you have to put the date that the bank decreased the account, because that's the moment that the customer started owing you the money specifically for that bounced check. And in our little example, it's April 1 of 2017. Now, all you have to do is choose the item that we just created, customer's bounce NSF check. It's not taxable, so if your QuickBooks Online is having technical issues like mine, you just have to make sure that that's not checked at all. And you have to put in the amount that they owe you, 2660. That's the amount of the bounce check, and that's the amount that you are billing the customer for with this invoice. By simply creating this invoice and clicking Save and Close, your records will be fine. Don't worry about the invoice number. Okay? Now your records are fine. Now when you click the reports for the trial balance, you will be able to see that cash in bank was decreased in the very last transaction on April 1. Your bank records are now decreasing the balance to match the bank on exactly the same day that the bank decreased the account in their records. You can also check the trial balance for accounts receivable to see that accounts receivable just went up on April 1 for what you charged Candy for that bounced check. In fact, you can even go to the open invoice report and you can see that Candy now owes you an additional amount for that bounced check. And that's how you handle step number one. Now let's do step two. Record the fee that the bank charged your account as a result of the bounced check. That's very easy. Just use the checks window. So we click the plus sign and we go over to the checks window. The date is still April 1 of 2017. That's the day the bank charged you the fee. Now technically you're paying the bank. So you have to find the bank on the list of payees. You should really have your bank on the list of vendors so that you can pay them, or at least record giving them some fee that they extracted from your bank. And the expense account that relates to that will be your bank fees expense account. It's unlikely that you will have so many bounced checks that you would need a separate expense in the chart of accounts to track how much money you're losing for customers' bounced checks. Usually it just goes in the bank fees expense account. And make sure that you're deducting the check, or at least this transaction, from the correct bank account with the correct payee. And the amount that the bank charged you on that date was $30. This will put $30 of expense in bank fees and lower your cash in bank by the $30. When we click Save and Close, we can look at the report that is the trial balance, and you can see for the very first time bank fees shows up as $30 and your bank account has just been reduced by $30. And now let's do step three, charging the customer a service fee for managing the bounced check. Well, in order to do this, we can make another income account in the chart of accounts for other miscellaneous income, because it's not likely that you will have so many customers' bounce checks that you will need a separate income account to track the income of processing these checks. This other income account is already in the chart of accounts and you already know how to make it. However, the final step to set up for charging your customers for a bounce check is to make an item on the items list that represents what we will charge them as a fee. Let's go ahead and add that item and connect it to the other income account. We click the cog wheel and we go across to products and services. Click new, and again, it's better to put it as a non-inventory part so that you can remember that this is not the normal service that you would put on an invoice. And you type in fee for customer NSF check so that the customer can see this name when it's on the invoice and know what they're paying for. Now, the income account you have to connect it to is the other income account. And if you don't already have an other income account, meaning an income account that doesn't relate to your normal services, you can just go and add it to the chart of accounts the way we learned. But I already have it here. By the way, if you want to add it right now, you can scroll all the way up and click Add New and you can add it. But you already know how to do that. You can pause the video, go ahead and add it. Let's click Save and Close. Oh, by the way, in the new QuickBooks Online, when you make a non-inventory part, make sure it says non-taxable. That should be the default so you don't run into any problems. So that's how you set up the item that you're going to put on the invoice to charge the customer. Now, all you have to do is click the plus sign, choose invoice, make sure the date of the invoice is the date that they owe you the money, which is exactly the date that the bank recorded the bounced check. In this case, the invoice is going to the customer who bounced the check on you, and the item is fee for NSF customer check. I don't know why it said taxable when we chose non-taxable. Don't worry. Just put the amount of $50. Now, this last example is going to go very quickly and smoothly because we're already set up and we already know what to do. It's going to be the same bank fee of $30, and it's going to be the same $50 fee to the customer to charge them to process. But step one says April 2nd, the bank reduced the account by $6,000 because Alan bounced a check on us, and he bounced the February 26th check that was deposited on February 29th. It will be so quick and easy because we are already set up. Watch. We click the plus sign and we go over to invoice and we choose Alan and we simply put the date that the bank reduced the account, and we can put on the body of the invoice first the customer's bounced check in the amount of the original check that bounced. And on the next line in the very same invoice, we could charge them the fee for the customer's bounced check. Don't let it be taxable. $50. And then we do that. Now the customer knows they have to pay us $6,050. $6,000 for the original bounced check. And $50 is what we're charging them because of the bounced check. And click Save and Close. So step one and step three were done at the same time. Now all we have to do is record the fee. Click the plus sign, click check. Again, the date should be the date that the bank deducted the fee from your account. The customer is the same customer. Actually, the payee is the bank. Excuse me, this is a check. So the payee is the bank that took the check from your account. And of course, the expense account should be bank fees unless you really have a lot of customers who bounce checks and you need a separate expense to track that. That's very rare. And the amount is $30. Save and close. Congratulations. Recording a customer's bounce check was that easy, and all you have to do is print this invoice and mail it to the customer.